Everybody, it's Invicta, and welcome to your first look here at Battle Chasers Night War, brand new JRPG like that was just released October 3rd. I will say as a disclaimer really quickly that I did receive a copy of this game after I requested it from the developers Airship Syndicate. So thank you very much to the developers for providing me with this key. It looks like a great game, as you saw from the intro here, and I wanted to make sure everyone saw that. The art style is fantastic. The music in particular is outstanding for this game, which I'm sure you're going to be hearing a lot of here. I don't know how long this video is going to be. As with most RPGs, it's probably going to take a little bit of time to start really getting involved with the gameplay and the mechanics. I will say really quickly, I don't know anything about the game other than that I watched CoCarnage play a little bit on his stream. I also watched Cry. He covered a video on it, and he also played a little bit earlier today as well. And I wanted to do a video here because it might be a pretty good game to do a full-fledged series on. I don't know how much content is in the game, but from all the reviews and from what I have seen so far, it is an absolutely stunning game. And I'm a big fan of JRPGs as well as RPGs. So it's got a little bit of roguelikes mixed in there. It also has a little bit of action RPGs along with that, but the JRPG side mostly comes from the combat, which is turn-based and that sort of thing, sort of an old-school Final Fantasy way. So without further ado, let's hop into it. Again, as a quick disclaimer, I did receive this key from the developer after requesting it, just so everyone is clear, and I've also probably put a disclaimer somewhere down in the information box. This is also simultaneously recorded on my Twitch channel, so it is possible you might hear a pop-up or two, but you're not going to see them at all. That's just so people can hear, watch me live and watch me stream it on Twitch, but also, of course, to give you all fine fans out here on YouTube a little bit of a taste of Battle Chasers Night War. And then you can also tell me if you want to see a series on it. So here we go. We're just gonna start a brand new game. I don't even know if I'm supposed to play with a controller or a mouse and keyboard. I'm just gonna go mouse and keyboard, and if that sucks, then we'll switch it up. New game. I'm not gonna skip this, because we're probably going to need to see this. Unless this is just the credits. If this is just the credits, then I'll... With respect and apologies to Airship Syndicate, I don't need to see the credits. Here we go.
Years have passed since the great warrior and leader of men, Aramis, vanished. Left behind were his mighty gauntlets, artifacts of untold power, giving their wielder the strength to move mountains, as the stories were told. Also left behind was his daughter, Gully. She discovered her father's gauntlets, setting in motion the events that would make her a target of great importance and bring her into the company of her greatest defenders. Nolan, the wise and mighty wizard, whose tongue is as sharp as his wit. His mysterious companion, Calibretto, a war golem of immense power. Garrison, a swordsman, once brother-in-arms to Aramis, now sworn to protect his only living kin. And the rogue, Red Monica, who can be foe as quickly as friend. Together, they have traveled the capital lands while defending Gully from those who seek the power of her gauntlets for themselves. Nolan, on a personal quest to learn more about mana, which fuels the world's magic and technology, has led the group towards a mysterious landmass known as the Crescent Isle. There, vast reserves of mana were once rumored to exist. As they approach the island, they quickly discover why so little is known about the area.
All right, so a little bit of story there for you. I'm actually going to turn up the volume just slightly. It might mute when I alt-tab, which it did, of course. I really like wish games wouldn't do that. I'm going to turn up the volume just a hair, not too much, because the music honestly is so good it has to be heard. Also, I've been told that the voice acting is excellent in this game, so everything combined looks like we're in for a good old-fashioned RPG hoedown. I don't even know what that is.
Everyone hang on.
What are you waiting for? Shoot back!
With what? It's a stealth ship.
This is stealth?
Just do something.
It's always on me, ain't it? These kids don't know how easy they've got it.
We're being boarded!
Gully, get below deck.
You break easier than I do, remember?
More incoming, port side.
Oh no!
Gully, what?
Gully.
I've got you. All right, Red. Looks like it's just me and, figures.
All right, I wasn't expecting to have an intro cutscene, but there you go. As you rise in levels, my computer's too fast, apparently. So as you can see, the art in this game is extremely stunning. It's almost like a watercolored paint on canvas here, and it's beautiful. Please be nearby. All right, so we are Gully, the main character of the story. We've got inventory, we've got special attacks, but like I said, the combat is turn-based here. So WASD, it looks like, to move. Spacebar is to do that attack, I guess. I just used up a charge. All right, so we have 5 charges. I'm guessing that's O, or is that Q? It's gonna be O. This is our dungeon codex. There is loot in randomly generated dungeons, at least I've been told is partially randomly generated dungeons. We have we have fishing equipment. Ooh, and look at all the fishieries. Neato. All right, let's hop to it here. I'm not sure if the cursor is gonna mean anything or not, but if I have to go hide it, I will, but I'm trying to keep alt tabbing to a minimum. Debris. Or as we say in America, debris. Liking the sound effects. Hey, it's Carbadio. Get his name already. Calibretto? Bretto, there you go.
Yes, are you feeling better? You've been resting for a few hours.
I guess I wasn't completely prepared for that cannon blast. Was I dreaming, or did you leap off the ship to catch me?
I did.
How'd we make it down in one piece?
Nolan. We fell through a portal he opened, placing us on the ground with only minor impact.
Then what happened to him?
We don't know.
And Garrison?
Garrison fell through the portal as well. Monica appears to be missing, along with Nolan.
Then let's get moving. They could be hurt.
Garrison already went ahead to search for them. Are you sure you're well enough to move?
I'm so woozy, but we don't have any time to waste. I'll be fine.
First, allow me to further heal your wounds.
Okay.
Then we will meet Garrison.
Alright, so Calibretto has joined the party. Switching party members X and Z. Each party member has their own unique dungeon skills. You can swap out an active party member in order to use each abilities to explore and interact with the world. You can open up the compendium and check skills in the skill section to see what each hero's dungeon skills do. Calibretto's revitalized dungeon skill can heal the party. Try swapping to him and heal your party. Alright, so this is how I like tutorials to be made. I basically enjoy games that allow me to do by learning, instead of just telling me and then making me read and stuff. So right now, we are Calibretto. I'm pretty sure it's Calibretto. Whoa! Easy there, Battle Chasers. You're scaring the kids. I can swap back to Gully at any time here. What is that? Hey! All right, here is the combat. The slime says, Alright, so this is the main combat screen here. You see the turn order on the left-hand side. This is actually the first fight that I'm ever going to do, so I might be a little bit not so optimized on here. We have scattershot, protection, we can use items, we can also flee. Let's go ahead and start off with a jab here. Yeah, let's go for a jab. So again, you see here this turn-based mechanics fully animated and look really, really good. So we don't know anything about this slime yet. 26 damage to Gully. And then Bretto's gonna go next. Defense Matrix. What is that gonna do? Reduce all damage taken by 40% until the next turn. If attacked while active, generates 5 overcharge. I don't know what that's gonna be. I'm just gonna activate it anyway. There you go, all defense up. Hover over status symbols with the cursor in combat or in the dungeon to get information about buffs and debuffs. Fantastic. That's what this is. So that's what Defense Matrix is. Defend. What happens if Gully defends? Reduces all damage taken by 50% until next turn. Yeah, but we kind of want her to attack. All right, then we're going to go for a gut punch here as we are way faster than slime. There we go. We get some XP. Check it out. We get some loot as well. We got some simple slime core. I like it. 112 total XP. Alright, we have a big blue glowing arrow over here. As you rise in levels, the Beastmaster may have new ways to unlock further potential in your heroes. Sweet. Who is the Beastmaster and where can I find them? Garrison went to northeast to look for Monica and Nolan. We should head in that direction. I'm sure they're fine, but we should hurry just in case. Alright. I got an achievement called Survivors, as you see down here. Yeah. I guess we're just gonna go check this out. Oh, it's actually gonna be a battle. I thought it was gonna be a dungeon. It's a ruins bat. More of you. We got 10 overcharge. I'm not sure what overcharge does. I'm sure we'll figure it out. There we go. We got Sunder, which probably reduces his armor or something like that. Let's see what Gut Punch does. Implies Sunder increasing physical damage. Oh, it increases physical damage taken. Neat. There's just something very satisfying with seeing a 13-foot robot punch a bat right in the face. Got common parts. There is a lot of crafting in this game, by the way. The crafting system is a big point that the developers wanted to touch on. Take all the loot, of course. We got a Veil Scout's tunic. All right, so that can be worn by Gully, and it gives us more physical defense, magical defense, reduces attack power, but also gives us stamina. But we need level 3 for that. I wonder what stamina is. I guess we'll find that out. We're not level 3 yet, though. Saw something glowing down there, but we're going to have another battle here against the bats. So there's a dungeon mode and then there's overworld mode, which is what we are in right now. And I believe that the dungeon mode, that's where you get the dungeon abilities from. It would seem to make sense. Big hit. Haste up. Oh wow, yeah, that actually gave him a lot of haste. There we go. Not really worrying about using abilities right now. With it being 2-on-1, I think we'll be okay. Just to save time, I'm gonna skip the looting screen a little bit. We found, who is this?
Gully.
Oh, it's,
I'm glad you're all right.
Garrison.
What you did during the airship battle, shielding the cannon blast.
You would have done the same for me.
Maybe, but with messier results. You're a brave kid, but remember, we don't fully understand the power of your father's gauntlets. You have to be more careful with them.
I had no choice.
No, I guess not.
I believe he was trying to thank you. Have you found any sign of Monica or Nolan?
I haven't. And this village looks long abandoned. There are lights on the horizon, to the east. Might be a town.
We should investigate. If they survived, they likely headed that direction.
What do you mean, if? Nolan saved us. He can save himself. And Monica, too.
You're probably right. Let's go find them.
Alright, Garrison has joined the party. Neat. Handwritten journal entries scrawled up on parchment. General Xavier has returned from the main front last night. Because he came in darkness, few got a good look at him, other than to say he seemed well. The wars elsewhere have taken their toll on the outpost, with ranks thinning, and our defensive practices becoming lax. Not sure Ravenheart even bothered to take his patrol last night. But then he always did seem a little the lazy sword. Hey, I know the feeling. That should change with Xavier stalking the halls once more. Car lost. Alright. I know there's other pages there, but eh. Now we have 3 versus 1. Alright, so these are... Oh, okay. So the abilities actually just cost mana. I'm guessing mana probably doesn't regenerate. Let's see what this looks like. Abilities. Let's go for Healing Wave, and we're going to heal Gully, and then we'll use Swift Strike on the slime. So I'm guessing those are queued up. Overcharge. Here we go. Overcharge is displayed in red next to your mana bar. It is generated by using regular actions. Overcharge is consumed in place of mana and used for bonus effects on certain abilities. It goes away after combat, though, so make sure you use it while you can. Okay, so it's just temporary mana, but it can also be used to boost your abilities. Certain abilities, that's pretty neat. So mana is probably going to be a pretty important resource. But you can use overcharge instead. Very neat. We're here to play, not to read, is what the... But Twitch chat said, I agree. We're here to get the fat loots. That is a very big spider. I don't like it. Scattershot, what does Scattershot do? Its damage shield on the ally absorbs 31 damage. Deals 16 damage to a target and 8 to a nearby enemy. Alright, well with two targets, I'm gonna cast on the spider. The cleave, rally strike, 34 damage. Increases haste of all party members by 10% for 2 turns. Sure, we'll try that. And then here, we'll go for a healing wave on Gully. I guess he just picks up a rock and just hums it right at the spider. I love it. There's the heal on Gully. Not bad. Everyone gets a haste boost. I did see that little overkill part, which was pretty neat. I think we just go for jabs here and be done with it. Don't forget to conserve your energy for more difficult fights. That was what a crit looked like. That was pretty good. There you go. I'm going to assume that didn't say diaper silk and instead that said dapper silk. The road sign leans precariously to one side. North is harm's way, south is wilderness. So we can inspect these little foothills here, or those diamonds, I should say. Be the village. See a few lights, but no people. I wonder where they are. Bang on a few doors. Alright, so the game wants me to go click the yellow exclamation point. I immediately are going to go to the white ones first. Curio shop. This door is oddly shaped. So this oddly shaped hut is locked. Strange tinkering sounds can be heard within. Tinkering continues, but no one answers. Fair enough. Looks like a tavern.
Hungry?
Let's chat. Where are we? Dude's got some wicked ink. It's a sign on the way in. Hey, you know what? I don't need this kind of sass. In the town of Harm's Way. Don't worry, the name's more bark than bite. What tavern is this? The Disemboweled Traveler.
Yeah, have a seat.
Alright, well, thanks.
Safe day.
Alright, so there's the inn. Book of Secrets. What made sign hangs from an oil gargoyle on the door. Reads, out to lunch. Rip the sign down and throw it in the dirt? No, that's rude. We're visitors here. Beastmaster Raha. Or Raha. Well, well, we have fresh band of adventurers. Sorry. Greetings, heroes! Welcome to Battle Chasers! Hello, Uncle Deckard. You're looking very scantily clad today. My name is Beastmaster Raha Kane. We have a fresh band of adventurers loose here in the Vale. Experienced ones, no less. We've seen our share of battles, and you, Uncle Deckard? Ha! I have. By the way, a Diablo. And Leia. Though, by the way, you should hold on to your blade. Not the same kind. Let's just say my foe are the wilder kind. The name's Raha! Beastmaster Raha Kane! As I see it, the only foes worth fighting are the untamed kind. And lucky you, this island is littered with them. So we've seen. I'm guessing that's the slimes or stuff. Ha 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 ha! The slimes and bats in the woods around town? No, you're in for far worse than that. It's almost like you read my mind, Uncle Decker. We're here looking for lost friends, not hunting for trophies. Indeed! Many get lost on this island. Rescue mission or not, you could use some basic advice to survive here. Take this bestiary journal. Track the creatures you fought. You'll find it doing so rewards you with insight into their strengths and weaknesses, hero. Survive long enough, I'll point you towards more worthy tests. You may find it necessary when searching for your friends anyhow. Search will be brief. Make sure of it. It won't be gone as quickly as we arrived. I've heard that before, hero. Don't get killed, adventurers.
Stay upright.
Stay upright. Thank you, Uncle Deckard. All right. Let's go check out the wizard's tent or tower, whatever this is. The collector. Greetings, heroes. Welcome to... It's... Hi, Uncle Deckard. Overcharged cannon. Oh, my Gertie. We got epic and we got a booty blade and serrated claws. I think,
go find.
I don't think we have enough for you, Uncle Deckard. Alright, let's go talk to Grimbeard Smithy. The heavy iron door, radiant furnace, and proliferation of metalworking tools strewn about tells you this must be the smith shop. Well, the massive door's open.
You're the town smith?
Me? Who the hell are you?
That's a rough way to greet strangers.
Being strangers, you don't know how rough we get around here.
Sound a lot more Scottish now, Uncle Decker.
I suppose we're gonna learn quickly.
Hey, skin's got to be thick to survive in a forsaken land like this one. And your hammer better be heavy. Speaking of forsaken lands, how did you lot end up here?
We came in on an airship. As we approached, pirates ambushed us.
Sounds right enough. Though not quite pirates, as you see. Bandits. Simple as that. Just thugs full of hot air. But they've been a right pain in the ass recently.
Excuse me, this is a Christian stream, Uncle Deckard?
Bandits. Who do they work for?
Well, being bandits. Themselves, mostly. That said, they're acting differently the last few moons. Less scatterbrained. More... organized. As a few of us left a bit worried.
We were separated from some friends during the battle. We think they may have them, or know where they are. We'd like to chat with them.
Chat. A few weaklings came by causing trouble last dawn. Chased them off down the south road. You can head that way, if you think you'll find your friends.
If we don't, they'll regret it.
Keep your head up. They must have a camp down there somewhere. Hello? Don't get killed.
All right. Find the bandit messenger, Grimbeard Chase South. So we're heading south. And we cannot deviate from this road at all. So it looks like any conflict that we see on the road, we're just gonna have to deal with. We're not to be trifled with, indeed. All right, so I don't know if there is a. I'm not sure if there's hotkeys or anything. It doesn't appear to be. Let's go for the gut punch. Another crit, I'll take it. There we go, we got some loot, common parts, probably for crafting, I'm going to assume. Treasure chest over there that I would definitely like to get. I don't know what the three skulls mean, but I guess we're gonna find out. Bring it on. All right, so let's go for the gut punch. Gonna focus fire on the top one. Big hit. Already got the kill there, and yeah. We'll have Garrison, Mr. Broody Reaper over here. Damn. There we go. I think the one is the level. I originally thought that was the hotkey, but apparently that's the level of the mob that we're going up against. Hey, level 2! Unlocked Quake Fist, and we also unlocked Nature's Boon. Neat. Got Veil Herbs, Common Parts, Rough Wool Scraps, and Digger Silk. It wasn't Dapper Silk, it wasn't Diaper Silk, it was Digger Silk. So, I'm guessing that this means that it's a multi-wave encounter is my guess. Big hit on the Ruin's Bat. So let's go ahead and finish him off. He didn't die. I'm gonna go for Rally Strike so we can raise everyone's haste here. There we go. So I'm guessing after we're done with this one, is AoE heal. They're healed. Anytime an ally receives damage, they are healed for 3 HP. I think I'd rather just use the single target heal right now. And then we have overcharge right now, but I'm still going to wait. There's the heal. Let's see what Quake Fist looks like. Oh man. Neat. Yeah, so it's a multi-wave encounter. Pretty much exactly what I thought it would be. Very cool. Now we have no overcharge right now on... I forget his name. Let's go for the jab here. I like the idea of having overcharge. I think it's pretty neat. Let's see, abilities. Obliterate. Let's see what obliterate looks like. Deals 23 damage. If sundered or bleeding, the enemy takes an additional 7 damage. Ah, okay, so that's a combo ability. We'll just wait on that then. There we go. Very nice. Calibretto, Gully, Garrison. You can call him Bretto. He's my Bretto. My brother. It's Tempo. Strange campsite just off the road. Let's say camp. Alright, so now we are in an exploration area or a dungeon area. This is where we get the active, like the sort of ARPG slash roguelike elements built in here. Because I have heard and seen there are puzzles in the game that you may need to solve. Barricades in the middle of the forest, someone is here. Really? What gave you that idea? Was it the fire or the camping tent, Garrison? The barrel over here. Got 9 coins. Camp. Looks like someone was here recently. Well, certainly friends, the bandit Grimbeard drove off, maybe? Ambush! Oh! That guy is stealth, I guess? We'll take our chances, that's right. Alright, so we're gonna go for a Sunder. I'm assuming we cannot... Yeah, we can't actually attack him because he's stealth right now. He's untargetable. We're gonna go after the Armored Eviscerator. That is a, they're not taking a whole lot of damage. I wonder if this will actually get him out of stealth. Yes, it will, actually. Okay. So you can... So you can do a lot of damage like that. You can also, apparently, reveal them. Garrison's gonna need a little bit of help. Let's go for protection. I'll put a protection shield here on Garrison. Reduce all damage taken until next turn. If attacked while active, Garrison's attack power will increase by 5% for one turn. Sure, we'll play defensive and see what that looks like. So the Eviscerator's going to go next. Oh, maybe not. I feel like we should bring down him. He's casting something called Scorpion Strike. I don't know how I feel about that. Well, thank goodness we put that shield on Garrison. I'm gonna hit Bretto there. Alright, let's use some abilities here. Let's go for Warblade. Consumes up to 40 overcharge. Oh, wow. Okay, so yeah. So Garrison really needs to be... He needs to generate overcharge a whole lot. I guess that's the reason why his overcharge bar down here is so so big. Go for another Nature's Boon. And here, let's see. Protection, Quake Fist. I'll go for a Quake Fist on you. Oh, Bok the Messenger has been knocked out. And the game apparently does also, it auto-targets the next available mob, so I like that instead of skipping your turn. Alright, so how about you heal yourself up, Bretto. You go for a Rally Strike. And then Gully will go for a Scattershot, yeah. Well, actually, no, that makes no sense. Quake Fist, yeah. There we go. Yeah. Didn't even break a sweat. Oh, Garrison, you're so brooding. Unlocked Rage Wave. A letter opener and a bloody letter. Fair enough. This letter he was carrying was a seal. It must be important. What does it say? Hard to tell. It's half smeared in blood. It does say outsiders, which must be us. Also references an outpost. The smith in town may know what that means. I feel like this is going to get complicated. Because it's a RPG. Ooh, a chest. We got Cyclone, layered leather vest, and 19 gold, I'm guessing it's called gold. It's coins, not sure. So Garrison can wear this, and it gives him... It reduces his attack power by a whole lot. By 4. But I feel like that's worth it, so I'm going to have him equip it. There we go. And then this is for Bretto. Gains weapon damage, loses physical defense, magical defense, gains attack power, gains crit. Yeah. Go ahead and put that on him. And then the letter opener. We get plus serrated blade. Has a 10% chance on hit to make the target bleed for 17 piercing damage. Sure, why not? Sounds awesome. But less impact damage, but more damage over time chances. I like it. This is the type of UI that I wish more games would employ, because it's very, very, very easy to understand. I don't have to wonder what stats are being down. I don't even have to wonder what an ability does or a proc does. It just clearly in plain English tells you right there. So, big time kudos to the developers for that. And I guess we can just leave the way we came out. I was half expecting there to be like a portal to the exit or something like that. We can also heal. Let's have top everybody off. There we go. And yeah, you know what, Garrison, you can heal. You can lead rather. Killing an enemy will advance progress with all of the relevant beast perks. Completing a beast perk objective will grant permanent passive bonus to all heroes. Neat. So we need to go back into the town. But you know I'm gonna want to like explore here. If we bust. Hit him with a gut punch. Yeah, like I'm playing Darkest Dungeon with a flagellant. Big hit. Flawless victory. I still haven't paid attention whether or not our mana... I'm not sure if our mana is actually regenning out of combat or if it's the same. Let me look at it. All right, I have 95, 105, 90. I'm guessing it probably doesn't regenerate. There we go, big old hit. We got Sunder applied, which is good. I'm gonna use mana on Garrison just to see if it actually does regenerate. I'm pretty sure it doesn't. The slime also might die to this. Nope, he didn't die. Okay, good. All right, so Garrison's got 75 right now. Hey, level 3. We unlocked Barrier Swing and something else for Bretto. I didn't see. I definitely want to put I want to put this on Gully. There we go. What about abilities? Where's our abilities tab at here? Skills. Combat abilities. Okay, so he got Nature's Boon Wildfire. Fire 8 shots hitting random targets for 7 damage each for a total of 58 damage done. Okay, that sounds fun. Barrier Swing. Deals 24 damage, converting 75% of the damage into a damage shield applied to the most damaged hero at the time. That seems pretty good. Again, very clear, concise answers and an easy to find UI. An imposing door stands surrounded by moss-encrusted ruins. A thundering swamp lies at beyond, okay? I'm approaching the door. Using critical rating, okay. So we are in another dungeon area. This is the Southern Gate. And it's gotten a little rainy inside. What is this? What is this dungeon ability? Oh. Okay, so I'm guessing that we cannot... Yeah, we're not going to be able to progress anywhere yet. So I guess that's a dash, maybe? Leave the area? Sure. Alright, so we'll go ahead and leave that be for now. I do want that treasure chest, though. Anytime I see a chest... In an RPG, you know that, like, I want it immediately. Of course, I'm talking about a treasure chest, not just, like, chests. You know what I'm talking about.
Interrupted my work.
I believe we found the bandit you chased out of town. In his possession was a letter we were unable to fully decipher.
Hey, let's have a look. Yeah, ink looks fresh. Says something about an ancient weapon.
Anything else?
Outsiders arriving at the island. Likely to, complicate things.
Outsiders? Does that...
Well, it's hard to make out entirely.
Sorry.
But it speaks of the Iron Outpost. That can be sure.
What's that? And where is it?
Mightiest military fortification south of the Snores. Long abandoned. But bandits have been going in and out a lot lately. Sky's no way. Gate north of town is locked to keep people from wandering that way. Here's the key. Well, you look likely to survive. But just in case, I've got a fine weapon or two for sale here that may come in handy. If the talking turns to fighting. Some others around town have useful wares as well. You might ask around, see what you can find. If they answer your knocks, that is. Come on in.
Okay, so we can browse wares, might as well. A coast iron broadsword, a vented cannon. Yeah, these aren't really all that, like, particularly useful here, blacksmith. Grimbeard, whatever your name is.
You're back. And nearly in one piece.
So the cannon. Okay, and then we can navigate this by using the Q and R key. Very neat. I don't know if we can actually sell any of this stuff. I'm just going to hold on to it.
Right.
There you go. So now we're going to go check out the curio shop. Tinkering stops briefly, replaced by a few profanities. I'm going to knock again. Oh, Calibretto knocked. What's the meaning of this? Oh my, a war golem! Is that you, Uncle Deckard? That is almost fascinating enough to warrant my time. In Calibretto's voice, being fascination is a requirement? Question mark? Yes! Now please stop knocking and go away. I left my other mask in the plate doctor's outfit. I expect you to buff out the damage in my beautiful antique entryway. I hear you're going beyond the North Gate. Maybe you aren't as boring as I thought. Take this flask. It'll bring anyone who's fallen in battle right back up. Minor revival flask. Hey, there you go. They're limited, but you certain sure you will no longer have to pay me your visit.
Yes?
Yes? Yes! Uncle Deckard. We get a discount on Flask of Strength. The primary elements. These recipes for basic mana flask and flask of strength. Neat. Sure. I'll pick it up.
Interest, you're leaving.
Okay, well, I got his voice completely wrong, and that's okay. Yeah. Learn basic recipe for the minor mana flask and the flask of strength. Neat. So I'm guessing K is the... Yep. So this tells you how to craft stuff. So we need a small bottle, veil herbs, and common parts to make a minor mana flask. And then the flask of strength is a small bottle, broken lysolot fang, whatever that is, wood cap mushroom, and common parts. All right, so let's head on out here and go northwest. Check gate. Use the northern gate key. We're in the Ironwood. Probably be wrapping this up after a couple more fights, just to give you the overall impression of the game, though, and show you the combat. I am absolutely loving it. There's a bandit rogue and a ruined spider. And I can confirm that Garrison did not receive any mana back. So mana is a finite resource. That's good to know. Yeah, let's go for Wildfire. I don't know if that's able to target a stealth unit, but I guess we'll find out. Go for a Swift Strike on you. Hey, we got that bleed. Yep, you can definitely use it on a not on a stealth character. All right, first wave down. And a gunslingers. Ooh, two of them. Okay. Good hit there by Gully. You go for a cleave here. Not that much damage. Big cleave. And here, I think we just go for another wildfire. I should be careful with my mana usage, but at the same time, it's a freaking gun. How can I not use it? Scattershot? Sure. That seems like a really powerful ability. Double XP, check that out. 116 XP, I like it. We got some loot, 10 coins, scraps of hide, common parts, rough wool scraps, and digger silk. Very neat. I don't know what that is, but the ruins just off the road here. They look military. This must be one of the old iron posts. One of the iron outpost old way stations, which means the outpost is nearby. Should we search it? It doesn't seem like the highest priority. I mean, I'm gonna search it. Attack power. Measures the character's power. Okay. Abandoned way station, exploration area. So again, this is where the game sort of transforms into the dungeon crawler aspect outside of the overworld, and I really, really like that. Lieutenant Crusher. Oh, man. We got the toughest man in the world over here. And apparently, he's really fast. Lieutenant Crusher. Well, hello, Lieutenant Crusher. How about I introduce you to Lieutenant Wildfire? He's got a lot of HP. I'll give him that. Not get the bleed there from Serration. That appeared to have hurt. And overcharge there on Gully. Trying to build up Garrison's overcharge meter here, because I want to see what that special ability does when he uses it. There we go. So there's a little risk reward type thing. It looks like he's about to do an ability next. So there's a little risk reward aspect in trying in deciding whether or not you're going to try to build up overcharge or if you're going to just get in and do damage now. That looks scary. All right, so that did a lot of damage to Garrison, and he also got way bigger for some reason. Let's use a healing wave on Garrison. I mean, yeah. Garrison, now's the time. You want to use Warblade, a Rage Wave. I guess that's AoE, yeah. Consumes up to 40 overcharge, adding 0.3 damage for each overcharge used. There's the heal on Garrison. There's the shield. Didn't hurt. Oh! 48 HP. I think we go for another healing wave on Garrison. Tenet Crusher's almost dead. Yeah, this guy is no joke. Got the knockout. I wouldn't say that, Garrison. You almost died. Good fight, though. Everyone hit level 4. Very neat. Knockout gloves. Please let that go to Bredo. People on this island are strangely cryptic. I like that. He was here looking for something. If we don't find Monica and Nolan soon, we're going to get dragged into it. That does seem likely. Yeah, it does. Find them. Scraps of hide, faintly glowing powder, and 8 gold. No, actually this goes to Gunny. Or to Gunny, yeah. Gunny. To Gully. Stunning blow has a 10% chance to stun an enemy for a short time.
Welcome to the mosh pit.
I mean, we gain weapon damage and attack power, but we lose physical defense and stamina. I still think that that's probably going to be worth it, though. So let's give that to Gully. Aramis's legacy. Yeah. I see a pair of glowing eyes over there. This dungeon's not over yet. Looks like we've got a slime here. Alright, so it does look like that everyone does regenerate their mana when you level up, which is very, very JRPG-ish. Okay, so Garrison got poisoned. I do like that the game also... It also reflects the change of the gear here in the art. Like, it actually has a different... Like, Gully actually has different gloves now. That's really neat. I wasn't sure if I was imagining that or not. When I first redid their armor and stuff. But yeah, now I'm definitely loving that. So we got Simple Core, 2 common parts, and 2 gold. So this is a fishing spot? Sure. I don't know how to fish.
Welcome to the mosh pit.
Fishing is a fun, relaxing activity. It can also bring its own special rewards, okay? Just make sure you have a good enough rod and a lure equipped from the fishing section of your compendium. Walk up to the edge of the water and cast your line, okay? Once you have a fish on your hook, pull your rod in the opposite direction of the fish is swimming in order to reel it in. Be careful not to pull in the wrong direction, your line may break. Okay. So we're going to cast the line here. Go for a full cast. Almost full cast. There we go. That looks like a big fish over there. Also looks like a turtle. Fish on! Fish on! Got away. We didn't get it. Let's try this again. I do like that we have, it looks like there are maybe some River Monster fans over there. Hey, we got a fish. It was a turtle, actually. A peaceful turtle common around the island. 7.2 pounds. Neat. I kind of want the other one, the bigger one. Not sure if that's going to be wise to try to go for him. Got a fish. I don't think we're going to... Oh, no. All right, one more cast. By the way, I'm a sucker for fishing in games. Absolutely love fishing in video games. Fish on. Oh, we got you now. Oh, we got you now. Great catch. Beginner's luck. Jub-Jub, a unique fish said to be able to speak. Unfortunately, it died when you pulled it out of the water, so you can't test the theory. Worth a few shadow coins to a fishmonger. Oh, that's good. I am really digging this game. I hope that you all here on YouTube also are digging it. Like I said, if there's enough call for it, we may do just a full-fledged series. Moss-covered artifact shard. This piece of metal is very strange. It's an artifact shard. It being here is a bad sign. Didn't Grimbeer said something about an artifact at the Iron Outpost? Yes, this really does get worse and worse. Man's nearby. Is he looking for this? Probably, but it's useless outside of a collection now, I hope. Get back to the road. Fair enough. Twitch chat's not too happy that I killed the fish. Look, I'm sorry. I didn't know that I was going to kill it. I've lost that edge. I can no longer kill fish. I'm guessing we can't go into this door, can we? The eight grins at you wryly, appearing to wink with its one smoky eye. Okay. I think looking at us with only one eye, there's no obvious way to open it. Like some sort of riddle. Whatever the case, we can't open it now. I have to come back. Okay, so there are puzzles in this game that you have to solve. And I'm guessing that's one of them, which we will probably find out more. But I think we're going to wrap it up when we get back to the town. I do want to see what this is. Take all the loot. We got 8 times the Coast Iron Ore. All right. This is called a motivator. I'm not sure if this thing is going to explode or not when we kill it. Hopefully it doesn't. Okay. There we go. Common parts for loot. Very nicely done. Go check out this chest over here. Force loop, minor healing flask, and a hardened coast iron ingot. Bonus damage and haste. Ooh. Give that to Garrison. And there's more loot here. We got blade leaf, veil herbs, and 2 faintly glowing powders. I do want to see what's in this chest down here. Slime over there. There's also bandits. We got a Coast Iron Broadsword. Hang on a second. We lose serrated blades, but we gain a lot of bonus damage and stamina. I think that's got to go to Garrison. I'm a sucker for just high weapon damage. High impact damage, especially. And we're just exploring. You never know what we're going to find down here. Take all the loot. What is this? That looks like some sort of tank. Why not? That is not a tank. That is a spider. A spider and a bat. Big hit by Gully. Let's go for a swift strike on you. Take you out. I mean, so far, it does seem like we're handling these early game fights pretty easily. I have a feeling it's going to get a lot tougher. Just going to build overcharge here for the next wave. First wave is done. Gonna be a slime and a wild gunner. Okay, so let's take out the slime because we know that that's easy. Got the sunder going. Let's go for the jab. Big hit by Gully again. Well, that ability just looked ridiculous, and I love it. Hit him with a rally strike here. You go for obliterate. And you go for a quake fist, sure. So there's obliterate, even though we didn't have Sunder on it. Another victory. Not too bad. Got a vented cannon and a bunch of crafting material. So it's only a white quality item, so I'm guessing that we're not. By the way, there's a random loot system in the game as well, by the way. So it's not. I don't know if these are all guaranteed loots in the sort of tutorial-ish area that we're in right now. But I do know that there's randomly generated loot. And that excites me a whole lot because I love that kind of loot system, especially in a JRPG type setting. And even more especially considering that it does change the appearance of your heroes. Arcane Sick and Sunder. What is Arcane Sickness? Increases magic damage and taken by 10%. Seems kind of bad. There we go. So we're just face rolling everything down here. I didn't want to take the loot. We got another Veil Scout's tunic. Pretty sure it's the same tunic that we just got for Gully. Yeah. Literally the exact same. Good. So that's. I don't mind getting redundant loot. Means we can sell it and maybe buy something cooler. There's an arena over there, it looks like. But I'm going to make my way to the quest item here. Or the quest marker. And wrap up the video. I'm having too much fun with the combat right now. Turn-based is completely fine if it's done correctly. One-off lethal counted, by the way. I mean, fans on my channel are a fan of Darkest Dungeon, which is about as turn-based as it gets. And this is decidedly not as Darkest Dungeon-y yet anyway. But we can still have a one-off lethal counted. I think it's appropriate for any game, really. I've got a rogue and a ruined spider. You know what? Let's just go for the wildfire, yeah. And we can go for a cleave here if we want to, sure. And you just go for the jab. Looks like Garrison's gonna resolve next. There we go. And then that should be game over for the rogue. Nicely done. There we go. Progressing very nicely. Now, these gates kind of look like the burning portal, the dark portal from WoW. The Iron Outpost. Oh, okay, here we go. So there's challenge modes. What? Though in ruins, the former scale of this mighty fortress is evident. Nature's begun reclaiming the old stone, and the smell of moss weaves with the salted breeze swirling around the entrance. Now crawling with bandits, it's time to figure out what power is drawing looters and criminals to the ancient site. Well, we've got to go average. I mean, come on now. We're no pansies over here. We got to be manly men, and also manly women for Gully, not Fern Gully, by the way. All right, so we're doing the heroic or the average difficulty. I don't know what this is going to entail, but I guess we'll figure it out.
This is the Iron Outpost.
It's well lit for an abandoned outpost.
Our approach hasn't been subtle. We should be prepared for resistance inside.
When are we not prepared?
You are not prepared. Sorry. Which chat says heroic or riot? I don't know. Oh, so. So it looks like you can avoid combat sometimes. Mana Gunslinger. This will be easy. Oh, he's level 5. Another talking corpse. That's a little presumptuous, don't you think? He's got a lot of HP. I'll give him that. Gully takes a little bit of damage here. Swift Strike. All right, let's get a heal going on, we'll heal Gully. Gully, you can use Quake Fist, yeah. He's pretty fast. Garrison hits pretty darn hard, though. So there's the heal for Gully. She gets topped off. Big old Quake Fist gets the knockout. Not too bad. Ooh, 52 XP for that. We got some loot. Grab some hide. See the bandit right here. Oh, I saw that trap. I did see that trap game. So we can't do anything right now unless we can use Rage Wave to get him out of stealth, but I have a feeling we're not going to need to do that. I guess just parry, sure. And let's use a minor healing flask on Fredo. Oh wow, that actually heals for quite a lot. All right. And then we can use Wildfire to get him out of stealth. Double poison. Got the crit. Oof, that's a lot of damage. Go for the jab. Should be it. Lights out. Gully with the big punch. Yeah, nicely done. Common parts. Oh, okay. So that was not a trap. Well, I guess it was a trap. It was just a slime trap. I mean, I'll take the free XP. Don't get me wrong. These guys are level 4. I'll go for a heal here on Garrison just to top him off. I realize that I should probably be generating overcharge before I use any abilities. Wow, that hits so hard. 34. Yeah, calm down over there, green slime. Scaring the kids. There we go. All right, well, there's a portal over here or something. Also a book. And it reports. This appears to be an undelivered letter. Boss, I got a problem. An airship has got past the patrol. Made it almost ashore, but I can't explain. It was fast. Pilot was good. We had the light armada on him, but then this wizard, he shot lightning out of his eyes and took half the fleet out in one whiff. Got on board, but one of them cut up about 50 of our men by himself. Then there was this kid with these glowing gauntlets. Had strength like we couldn't figure out. She punched one of our ships out of the sky all by herself. We hit her square with the guns. She just stood there smiling. We took their ship down over western shore, but couldn't find no sign of them. Sure, they're dead, yeah. The fall was impossible. We'll keep an eye out, but please don't send one of them freaky bone men to whoop the guys. Thank you, stereotypical Texan bandit. So this is a map? Mapu? I guess that's the key telling us where we can go. I don't really want to use my heal if we don't have to. Okay, so that represents where the next tile set that you can move to. Got it. Bandit reports. Appears to be undelivered letter. Boss, few ships came by in sea. Came in by sea. Sorry, I've been drinking a little bit tonight. Tried anyways. We took care of them pretty quick. The boys pulled a few survivors out of the water. We'll bring them your way whenever we can. Seems they'll be useful for whatever it is you're doing. I don't want to know. We're still digging through the outpost trying to find the thing. Be a lot easier if you just told us what it is, meaning no offense, of course. In fact, forget I asked. Guess I just could cross that sentence out on this one. Nah. We'll take payment the usual way. Last batch was too fermented, by the by. Gold was just fine, though. Sincerely, hugs and kisses, Givens. Oh, man. So there's like an entire... That was a bat. That was a big old bat. If we must, we must. Getting into the good stuff now. Swing and a miss. do like that I can skip by the loot pretty quickly. Hey there, stow your weapons and we'll have no quarrel. I'm not much of a fighter. I'm more... Excuse me. I was talking to the man. Game. Use a cleave, yeah. You, let's use a gut punch. I don't think that thing has any guts, so... And this, we use scattershot. We haven't used scattershot yet. Let's take a look at it. Big old cleave. Oh, yeah. Wait, yeah, we have. She just throws the rock and it splinters off. That's right. So the motivator hasn't gone yet. We might want to heal Garrison, but I'm going to take a chance and not. Didn't get the kill on the motivator. And they're going to hit Gully. Whoa! Or they're going to hit the entire party, okay? Yeah. Let's not have you ever do that ever again, ever. And then you... ...94 HP. Good lord. Okay. Let's get the heals out. Gully is, like, almost dead. So is Garrison. Garrison, sorry, buddy. You're going to have to use a potion for this. And then Gully, you can still go for damage. Oh, we got the stun. So I guess he's stunned for one turn. That's good enough. It's armored eviscerator, though. Or is he stunned for three turns? No, he was just stunned for... I think he was just stunned for two turns. All right, healing wave yourself. And... yeah, you know what? Let's go ahead and use a Warblade here. I didn't get the healing wave off in time. So Bredo is currently taking a nap. We were able to get the kill, though. I don't know if that's going to count, if that's going to count against some sort of score or something. Unlock Taunt, Swift Cleanse, and Sting. Blade Leaf, Common Parts, Reinforced War Golem Plating. Whoa, fancy that. So, oh wow, it's a blue as well. Yeah, definitely want to give that to Bredo. My Bredo. Weapon damage, but we lose crit. Letter Opener, I think that was the old sword that we had. What is everyone's status? Okay, so yeah, so he's fine. I do want to see what the combat abilities we got. All right, so we got Swift Cleanse. Removes two debuffs from a single ally, okay. Taunt. Draw the next three attacks to Gully, reducing the damage of each by 10%. Generates 5 overcharge, an additional 5 overcharge when attacked. Ooh. Then Sting. Deals 12 damage, generates 20 overcharge, applies bleed, 22 damage over 3 turns, stacks 3 times. Oh, man. Okay. Hey there, store your weapons. I'm not much of a fighter, more of a gambler. I find it's faster and less bloody way to earn gold. What do you say? You want to try your hand at Lady Luck? Just a simple coin flip, nothing fancy. Odds are 50-50. Swear on my honor. I believe you, bandit. Ready? Call in the air. Flips coins. Call it. Always heads. Comes up tails, we lose. Sorry, friend. We can't all be winners. I'll just be taking that now. So it's a fight you want. Can't say I didn't expect it. Get him! I'm getting my money back. There's 3 of them. Alright, so I'm going to have Gully defend. Actually, no, that's stupid. Barrier swing. Great, converting. Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, barrier swing here. We need to start building overcharge for Garrison right away. There's the bleed. And here we will go with a defense matrix. No, we don't need to do that. I thought about using it on Gully, but she hasn't taunted yet, so... 9 damage, double poison. So the damage shield went on Garrison. Wow, that did a lot of damage. Okay. So let's go for another stack here on the Bandit Gambler. Let's get that poison off of Garrison. Garrison's getting torn up right now. Definitely going to have to use another barrier swing. No, we can't do that because the bandit's turn's actually going to resolve before Gully goes. So we can have Gully taunt or we can have her defend. Protection. Let's put that on Garrison. Got it off just in the nick of time. Alright, Garrison, I'm going to have you do a Rage Wave. 44 magic damage each. Not going to kill any of them. I do want him to use a potion, but I'll probably have Bretto use a potion instead. Alright, Bretto, we're going to need you to heal Garrison. Those bodyguards do a lot of damage. We don't have any overcharge right now. We could go for another barrier swing, which I think is a good idea. Rage wave. Oh! Big time crit from Garrison. Let's get that poison off of him. There's the damage shield that we needed for him. So we have poison ticking now on Bretto. My Bretto. There we go. And let's have Bretto cleanse himself. And then we can just taunt. Yeah, we can taunt this guy. Alright, we have 45 overcharge on Garrison. They did get a crit off on Gully. Healing wave yourself, Bretto. I kind of don't want to kill him yet. But at the same time, I want to see how much damage a 45 charged Warblade can do. So there's the heal. He just died from bleeding. Now that was a fight. The robot being poisoned seems legit. I mean, yeah, cheater's ring. So he was cheating. The gambler always tries to squeeze as much money he could. Gold scrounge increases gold found in combat by 10%. Very neat. I think we did get our 50 back as well. Let's give that to, I guess, Gully for now. We can search this. Gambler won't be hassling anyone anymore. All right. So there's a lever here. Seems simple enough. I am going to use our combat ability, our dungeon abilities here for that. There we go. Oh. Gotcha. Then we need to go open up this one. Neat. A fair but challenging puzzle. Outpost tunic. Ooh, we got a Coast Iron Ring of Blades. That sounds pretty metal. Bonus damage and stamina. Let's give that to... I think that should go to Garrison. And then the Force Loop can definitely go to Bretto. Eat. So I'd say that was worth it. Alright, let's go in over here. There's a box here. Common parts, 5 gold. I'm definitely loving everything about the game so far is just fantastic. The art style really complements the gameplay very well. Common parts, 6 gold. This is the randomly generated dungeons that I was talking about. So we are actually going to get the motivator as well as the bandit brawler. Defense matrix. I'm going to put this on. We don't know who they're targeting, so let's just go for a gut punch. Let's try to get the motivator down because I don't want him to debuff anyone. We did get the Sunder on him. That's good. I'm going to have Gully taunt. Then we'll use a sting on the brawler. Alright, so I'm going to cleanse Gully because I don't want her... I basically don't want her to be sundered or anything. We can go for a scatter shot, we can go for a protection or barrier swing. Let's go for a barrier swing on the motivator. Not too bad. There we go. Alright, so the damage shield went to Gully herself, which is good. And we can use a healing wave on Gully. It's only going to cost 5 mana. I kind of really hate that attack. You are not prepared! Where have I heard that before? Alright, we got 3 stacks of the bleeding up here on the brawler. Big heal on Gully. Alright, let's start throwing out some abilities here. Let's go for... Yeah, let's go for a Quake Fist. That was a 35 crit by the motivator. Definitely want to go for a Warblade. We're going to go ham and turkey on a... Turkey taco, ham bone biscuit over here. Should probably get a heal on Garrison. Big hit, 73 on the bandit. Arcane Sickness is going to increase the amount of damage that they take. The bleed actually was enough to kill the brawler, which is nice. And I think that we just go for another taunt here. I don't think this thing can be bled. Doesn't really matter. There we go. I mean, so far, combat seems challenging but fair. I keep clicking past the loot. I apologize for doing that. I need to stop doing that. New common parts. I've been playing Monster Hunter Stories so much. I'm not used to looking at the loot anymore. Bandit reports, 2 of 4 more intruders. Boss! 2 more ships, this time from the south. 1 boat, 1 airship. Boat sank fast enough. Airship got away. Weren't our fault, though. It's fast. Faster we've ever seen before. Took damage, though. Saw more than a few sorry souls fall overboard during the scuffle. Didn't bother fetching them. They were shark bait after that tumble anyway. But yeah, it got away. Might get more company around here soon, assuming the ship can make it more than a few clicks before the last engine gives up. Why is he suddenly so military? Won't happen again. Hugs and kisses. XOXO. Love, Givens. Thank you, Givens. Alright. So we've cleared this tile. We're going to head back to the other one. I guess we're going this side. We've already read that, have we? Yes, we have. Alright, so there's a spider. There's also a workbench in there or something. I don't think the spiders speak English, Garrison. Just call me kooky, call me crazy. Let's go for a sting on you. And we're gonna have 2 poison charges here on, or actually, no, just 1 poison charge, no problem. We'll go ahead and cleanse that. There we go, big hit by Gully. Oh man, sting is just too good not to use. Venomous Bite's gonna give Gully another poison here. Again, I'm gonna cleanse that. Yeah, she does resolve next in the move list here. 21 damage, not too bad. go ahead and use a rally strike, rage wave, war blade. That's a big hit by the spider. Even bigger hit by Garrison. Alright, so let's see what this workbench is all about over here. Mainly glowing powder, veil herbs, common parts, or gold. Oh! It's crafting. It's a crafting bench. So you can craft your stuff if you need to inside of the dungeon. Because I'm assuming that you can't do it right now. You found the dungeon map. Hey! Neat. I don't know how we get to the map, though. It's M. Oh my goodness, this is a big dungeon. Okay. Those traps over there. I'm guessing we're going to use Garrison to shadow step over that. I do kind of want to see what's over here. I see this rogue. Alright, so Garrison going to go for the sting. And the bandit rogue's already almost dead. I mean, let's just kill him. I agree, Brando. That was a pretty easy fight. Got some loot, scraps of hide. All right, so we're going to use Garrison to use his, I guess, dash ability. Yep, that's exactly what it is. Another brawler and a bat. Apparently the brawler's really fast. Alright, let's go for... we should probably... Let's make a little bit of overcharge first. I should focus the bat down. The bat's not going to be the problem. The brawler's going to be the problem here. I'll have Garrison take out the bat. I know that's not focusing him down, but listen. I'm not very good, okay? Gully's taking a little bit of damage here. And let's go for... It's only going to use 5 mana to use the barrier swing, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. She's going to bring it. So the overcharge... I wonder if it gets used... Like the shield that she generates... Oh yeah, it definitely does. Cool. So she generates overcharge before she uses her abilities, then she is not charged for those abilities. That's pretty neat. So you could do some real metagaming there, fully expecting to get an overcharge, since you can see which turn that, which person's going next in the resolution phase over here. You can try to predict when, if you're going to have enough overcharge for an ability, for example. That's pretty neat. Gonna go for a taunt again. Big heal on himself. Bretto, let's go for some more overcharge goodness. Plenty overcharge now on Gully. That doesn't look good. That definitely does not look good. Big hit on Gully, but she's okay. I kind of don't want to kill him right now. And the reason why I don't want to is because I want this heal to go off. So I'm going to actually just parry here. You are just going to defend. Right. Luckily the brawler went for Gully. She's still taunted, so that's okay. Gully has 35 overcharge now. Take that 45. All right, I think we did okay with that. Common parts, scraps of hide, I'll take it. I'm getting a little bit worried about our HP though. Late leave common parts. All right. History of the Iron Outpost, Part 4. Past appears to be from old textbook. Decades after construction, final order, blah, 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 blah. Okay. I'm not much of a lore guy, unfortunately. Got a trap. Don't want to get hit by that. I'm assuming that does AoE damage to everyone in the party if we do. Channel outpost. Okay. There you go. If you, for anyone here on YouTube, if you want to read this, I'll go ahead and let you pause it. Not much of a lore guy. The gameplay so far has been exquisite. Alright, so we're going to go to... Oh, we needed to go north in there. Fair enough. I forgot that there was a door over here. Oh, not over here, in the other room, of course. Of course, what was I thinking? I don't really want to use the out-of-combat ability for Bretto right now on Gully. I'd rather save that in case everybody needs a heal. Oh, scrolls over here. Wars of War! Such greatness. Handwritten journey, intro scroll, and parchment. General is a man of glory, truth be told. I'll let you pause it if you want to read it. And apologies to my Twitch viewers, because I know that you guys and gals can't pause it. I am simultaneously recording this for YouTube. For those of you who are wondering why I'm not reading chat or responding to anything yet, that's the reason why. Drink from the Shrine of Health? Sure. Regenerate health in combat. Neat. I mean, it's called the Shrine of Health. What could possibly go wrong? Nothing is the answer.
Hold there. You will go no further.
We can end here if you tell us where our friends are.
Dead, certainly. Not they will be. After we kill you.
Sorry. After we kill you, you shouldn't have come here, outsiders. Alright, well, it looks like it's our first boss battle here. We got some hip-hop music going. Kind of like it. It's not really hip-hop. More smooth jazz. Alright, let's go for a... I'm gonna instantly go for Healing Wave on Gully, because she is kind of low. And we should take out the adds first. Definitely gonna go for a taunt here. Gully's gonna take a lot of damage. Gonna use defend because she right now she's still taunting, so she's just here to soak up damage. Big hit. Yeah, that's good damage mitigation there. Apparently they can shield themselves too. Very interesting. I'm gonna go for an obliterate on the warden here. Double poison on Gully. She's still okay. Let's go for a rage wave. Definitely want to get the cleanse off of her. All lightning. Yeah, so she is not taunting anymore. Let's go for a barrier swing. We could go for protection. I feel like if we're going to do that, we should just taunt and defend. Could use Quake Fist as well, but I'm worried about her incoming damage. Let's go for defend right now. Rage Wave! Boom! Almost got the Slinger. Actually, the bleed's gonna take him out. Nice. Alright, let's get a heal here on Gully. I'm so glad that I had her defend. All lightning again. Gully taking a lot of damage here. But now's when things get set into motion. I'm gonna go after the adds. Garrison already back up to 35 overcharge. The bleed should be able to take him out. Yeah, down he goes. So I'm gonna re-sunder the bandit warden. He's got a haste buff, it looks like. And let's also go for a warblade on you. Another call lightning. Go for a barrier swing. Thank goodness we got that healing life as well. Lasts for 3 battles. Pretty neat. Alright, here we go. Let's go for obliterate. Let's see how much damage this can actually do. It also works against bleeding targets as well. I think it only showed 13 because that's how much HP he had. Pretty smooth. Harrison, hero perks unlocked. Outpost tunic, rough wool scraps, and scraps of hide. Let's check this out. Outpost tunic. This one has thorns, though. So that's good for Garrison. He gains attack power, but he loses defense. I don't know if the attack power up by 8 is worth it. We'll try it out. Let's see here. I feel like there's other things we could look at. Thank goodness we found that dungeon map. I'm guessing that the boss is probably going to be at the very end over here. All right, so I'm going to go for just a taunt. Everyone's basically at full HP. I'm fine with that. So we can combo obliterate with sting. From Garrison, if he wanted to. Got the poison. I'm just gonna go for a gut punch here. Let's go for... Yeah, we'll go for another gut punch. And we are still taunting, so I'm gonna go for a defend. I don't think we can bleed this. Apparently we can bleed it. Sounds good to me. Yeah, I think that we'll have Bretto go for an obliterate this time. Let's see how much it does. Here we can go for a barrier swing. And here we can go for a warblade. I only did 44 damage, but it's still decent damage. Alright, damage shield went right to her, didn't even need it. Nicely done. I wonder what that perk is. I should probably go look at that. How much tank treads, I like it. Let's look at the heroes real quick. I don't know where I would do this at. Yeah, here we go. Perks. Okay, so this looks like it's talents. Crit chance up, rank 1. At the end of combat, Garrison heals for 18 health. AP up. Increased attack power by a percentage. I like that. Warblade 2, raise the amount of overcharge that can be consumed by Warblade from 40 to 80. Crit damage, and begin with a battle with 10% attack power for one action. I sort of feel like AP rank 1 would be... pretty good, although we could go for 2 of these instead of spending all 6 of the perk points. But having the amount of, you can just freely allocate them, apparently. That's pretty neat. That's so you can do that on the go. I like that a lot. I had no idea about that system. There we go. History of the Iron Outpost. Again, if you want to pause the video here to read it, go for it. Some ore. I'm gonna be honest. I was not expecting the. I was not expecting the dungeon to be this long. So I know this is a little bit of a longer YouTube video here. I also apologize to my Twitch chat. We're not responding here, but I'm gonna be courteous. We got a brawler and a spider. So we're still healing, which is pretty good. Let's go for a gut punch. Take out the spider. I don't feel like dealing with poison. 18 damage. The spider's dead no matter what after this turn anyway, so we don't really need to attack him. Or we could attack him and just let him die here. Probably do that. I don't want to give him an action. Alright, go for a healing wave on Gully. Gully, you can just taunt. And then Garrison can go for a sting. Oof. Big heal there. I go for defend. She's still taunting. I like the fact that defend generates overcharge. So Garrison is at max overcharge right now. Go for a gut punch here. Here we can go for a Quake Fist. Here we can go for a big old War Blade. So basic actions go on the turn, on this turn. They resolve after this turn. Or on this turn, I should say. Oh, 110, good lord. Garrison does tons of damage with War Blade, man. Hero perks unlocked, neat. See what kind of perks we got. That would be C for character. All right. Reinforced knuckles, crit chance, haste up, AP rank, critical retaliation. Increase attack power 25% for one action after being struck by a critical hit. Begin the battle with haste or scattershot 2. Kind of like that. Let's go for critical retaliation and reinforced knuckles. I like it. Bredo, let's see, crit chance 1%, stamina 2.1, defense matrix, grants extra 5 overcharge when hit, seems pretty good. Obliterate 2, AP rank 1, and physical damage defense. Go for that, and let's go for stamina. I'm not sure what stamina does, though. I do like that you can swap everything on the fly, though. That's very, very cool. He does kind of look like Garen from League of Legends. Name is Garrison. Okay. I'm not going to spend time to fish right now. Apparently this is... can we go to the right over here? Not a door over here this way. Unless I'm missing it somehow. Oh, there's stairs over here. Fair enough. I think I missed a chest over here. Nope, definitely didn't. Alright. We're gonna jog our way up the steps here. Never skip leg day. It's a terrible idea. Alright, so we're gonna go for a taunt. Same routine by now. Defense matrix. Let's just go for a good one. Go for a sting. That's an impressive amount of damage he can do despite the 10% down. I go for a defend here. Again, I like having Gully she just basically creates overcharge by getting hit. Soaking up the damage. I like that a lot. And let's go for... this is a free heal. I might as well cast that on Gully. You can go for a jab. There we go. Then we need a big Warblade here from Garrison. Oh, never mind. Never mind. Now, I also should probably remind people as well that I did put this difficulty up on the highest one. So I don't know how much that's factoring into us taking forever in here. Seems like a very overly intricate door. I'm gonna use Shadow Step or whatever this is, Dash or whatever it's called. Okay. I think we got both of them. Yep. Alright, this might get a little bit scary. The Eviscerator is the one that we have to watch out for. So I say we take out the Eviscerator first. He has bladed shield, so he's already doing thorns damage. We hit him with bleed, because, you know, of course you can. Why wouldn't you? It's a fantasy game. So barrage doesn't do too much damage. This is the one I'm worried about. 60 HP. That's while she was taunted, by the way. Gonna go for an obliterate on the Eviscerator. You're just gonna defend. And let's get another swift. Let's get another sting on the Eviscerator. This should kill it, I hope. Ooh, yeah, the bleed's gonna take it out. Very nice. Alright. We got past the scary part. We can use a Warblade here. And we should just get a heal. It's gonna cost some mana, but I think it's worth it. Get the heal, and then the Warblade will go off. Oh, man. 102. Yeah, we got common parts. I'm looking forward to seeing what kind of crazy stuff you can cast. An oddly glowing pool pulses with dark energy. You make out faint glimmers of some sort of treasure. Make sure the object inspect the pool. You notice that that some corrupt dark energy periodically expands and retracts. Though it follows a rhythmic, predictable pattern, still makes you feel a little uneasy. Okay. So I'm going to wait for it to go down and then grab it. Definitely you snag the treasure. We got an epic ring, Nature's Touch. Ring that reinforces one's constitution, bonus damage, and stamina. Ooh. Well, let's give that to, I guess, Gully. Get rid of that cheater's ring. I thought it was a little bit weird on that on the grammar there, or the wording, saying that you can reach for it now, but then also have that pulsing pool. So that's really neat. I really, really dig the design of the game. This motivator is trying to run away from us. Nope. Didn't get away from us. Motivator is also hurt for some reason. I wonder if it got hit by that trap. I'd prefer this thing not to do that AoE, so I'm going to taunt it. This thing, he is level 6, so I'm a little bit worried about this. I guess we're going to find out. No, he's just going to do a basic attack. So let's cleanse that off of Gully. And we'll go for a jab. The faster something dies, the faster it won't do any damage to you. There we go. Wow, even that rank of Warblade only did 85 damage. Or still did 85 damage, rather. That's... Garrison brings the pain, man. As brooding as... and as emotional as he looks. History of the Iron Outpost. Again, if you want to read this, go ahead and feel free to pause the video. Twitch chat, I don't know what to tell you. Moderate Revival Flask. There we go. This appears to be some sort of crystal. Heal and restore all mana usable only once. Sure. I suppose. Okay.
Hurry up.
What is that?
Bad news. Get ready.
Eat. What is... what is this? A blade fiend. Okay. Okay. I don't know what that is. First, attacking, healing, and taking damage all build up your party's burst bar. Once you've built up a full charge of burst, any one of your heroes can expend the charge to unleash their own unique burst ability. What? Alright. Well, this is going to be interesting. Got 540 HP. Thank goodness he can be bled, though. Curse of the Blade. Deals 5 piercing damage each time the target is hit during an attack. Yeah, let's not. Let's not have that. Yeah, the music is very, very good. We don't know what he's casting. Okay, so yeah, so I figured that was probably going to do a multi-strike attack, and I'm glad that I got that curse off of everybody. He's still taunted, so I'm still going to just defend here with Gully. And we're almost at full overcharge for Garrison. I want to get a third stack up. I'm going to cleanse... gonna cleanse Bretto. Alright, we're still actually taunted, so I'm just gonna keep defending here until something happens. Big time damage here, Garrison. Oh! 133 crit! Yikes! Hit him with a gut punch. We're still taunted, so I'm just gonna keep on doing this. So far, so good. Do we use our burst ability? Level 1, Heartbleed. Let's check it out. Deals 62 piercing damage, cause target to bleed, ignoring damage mitigation. Oh, now that is awesome. Even has custom animations for it. I'm in love. Still taunted. Again, I'm just going to keep on defending. Big heal there by Bretto. Uh-oh. Yeah, that would have been real bad if we had that curse on, so I'm glad that I took that off. Alright, let's get the taunt up. And for Bretto, I think we're going to have to heal. Go ahead and heal Garrison. I think we can just go for a Warblade and end it here. Gonna go for a defense since we're still taunted. There we go! Blade Fiend knocked out. Absolutely dunked upon. 400 XP. And we got a Coast Iron Broadsword and a small Blade Shard.
The blade they pulled from that thing was an artifact. This is more than some bandits screwing around.
The bandit who got away dropped this insignia as he fled. Have you ever seen one like it?
No, I haven't.
It sounds like we're paying Grimbeard at least one more visit.
Yes, we are.
There we go, we did it. Dungeon complete, the Iron Outpost. It's just the beginning. I got one heroic treasure cache. Take the insignia. Oh. Got it. So we got one red rusty blade. Is that usable? It is. 16 plus 4 bonus damage for Garrison. Yeah. And let's see if we can open this. What we get? We got Blade Leaf, Flask of Strength, Iron Coast Broadsword, Nature's Touch. So it gives bonus stamina and damage. Probably not going to use that. And that also gives stamina and more damage. It's actually better than the rusted red blaze sword, whatever it was called. Give that to Garrison, and this is probably going to be some rare crafting material. So, all right, everyone, I think I'm going to stop the video there, as this has almost been 2 hours now. But wow, this is one fantastic game. So again, I'm going to leave a link down below. You can check it out on Steam. It's in full release as of October 3rd today. I know this video is going up super late, but I wanted to get this out on release day. Again, special thanks to the developers for providing me the key. I did request it from them. They were kindly able and willing enough to give it to me. So thank you to Airship Syndicate, the developer of this fine game. And let me know down below in the comments if you would like to see a full-fledged series on this game. I think it would be pretty darn neat. And almost like it sort of has a Darkest Dungeon appeal to it. And the narrative seems pretty plot-driven, but also I'm a big fan of the loot that we get to see. So thank you for watching, everyone. I do appreciate it. Again, if you enjoyed this video, kindly let me know by clicking the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Either way, it helps about supports the channel. Subscribe if you'd like to see more of this game and others here on YouTube. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody!